So moving down to my crazy stereo bus scheme, I've never done this since with so many stereo buses like this, but it kind of worked for this particular thing. As I was saying before, let me just bypass them one by one and just show you kind of what they're doing. And if I take all the plugins off, because I always start off with one stereo bus and then I like make duplicates. And honestly, I'm looking at it now and I'm like, oh, it sounds good when it's all playing together, but the logic behind it in the moment, you know, I just do shit sometimes because I'm like, oh, I need to get this trash part, you know, to react a little bit differently. And I don't want this one to react with the things that are being sent to this one. So it's something along those lines. But again, I do things fast and I try not to overthink it. And I just make duplicates and kind of go and blend them together. So let me take all the plugins off. It's so easy to turn the world down, no matter. So it's like a whole different thing. As you can tell, like the glue, the saturation, the energy, everything is gone. And you know, by mixing into a few things that are adding different coloration and saturation, you can basically kind of create your own glue and vibe. And whether the way you mix into it as you're hearing it kind of informs it. Kind of the way mixing on an analog console used to. As far as like using all these parallel stereo buses, you got to check your phase. And you got to make sure things are staying in phase. And you got to make sure that the Pro Tools delay compensation is working correctly if you want to try stuff like this. If you're learning to mix, I would say don't go do crazy shit like I just did with six stereo buses. Is just try to do it with one. And normally when I make songs, I just try to have one or, you know, or maybe have one parallel in the sense of, you know, just keeping it simple, and simple is usually better. But definitely make sure your delay compensation is working good, that you have enough. You're not in the red up here, like this guy is not red, because you could have some terrible phase issues and suck the life out of your mix really quickly. So be careful with that and use it with discretion. For this track too, I didn't want it to be too pop bright. I wanted to keep it kind of dark. Dull is probably not the word, but like a warmth to it and a darkness to it, because it just kind of like went with the vibe of the music. Let's see. What do we got next? C4. Amazing on vocals. You have grown so much and now you're breaking every time you're laughing. It out. You have grown so much and now you're breaking every time you're laughing. Yeah, that's the money right there. The C4 is doing good work. I really like that. One more time with it. You have grown so much and now you're breaking every time you're laughing. Very good. And then what's going on here? Just took out the air. I didn't want it on this one and did another notch yet again. This one's real good because you don't really get much artifacts, if the right word, when you pull out stuff with this. But again, just kept pulling, just smoothing things out. You have grown so much and now you're breaking every time you're laughing. So on the every time you're laughing, you don't hear it as much, but on this part you do. Now you're breaking. Without. Now you're breaking. So you hear that note jump out and it just gets a little ugly right there. So I'm just trying to make it even. You could automate EQs. I do that a lot. You know what I mean? I do that probably more so in R&B and stuff like that. But in this, I did want it to have a certain quality that fit the genre. And I felt like, you know, it came up pretty good.